What's up, everybody? Welcome to Money Management Channel. My name is Andrei, and today I'm going to be doing analysis on BLIN ticker. And on today's video, first of all, I will show you where we are on a price chart and what might be the next potential movement. And then I will show you some fundamental news about this company, and we will continue with the probable outcome and with the forecast for this price. And before we get into all of that, if you guys would like to take a part in a limited time promo offer from Webull and earn two free stocks valued up to $2,300, just open new account, deposit only $5 and choose your free stocks. Link in my description. So let's start with the chart analysis. As you can see, we have two waves, and usually we have to have three waves, three impulsive waves in one motive wave. So, and for now, as you can see, we are sitting right on the 55 exponential moving average, and we are on 1 hour time frame. And basically, this is a rather good support. And on top of that, let me show you that we have a confluence level with this top, and we are sitting right above this level as well. And this might be next potential lowest point from this top to this potentially bottom, and from this point we might have one more leg to the upside. But let's continue with some fundamentals of this company. And we are on Seeking Alpha, and let me quote you the company profile. Bridgeline Digital operates as a digital engagement company in the United States. The company's Bridgeline Underbound platform enables companies and developers to create websites, web applications, and online stores. And this company has several products. Let me show you on their official website. They have a marketing automation product, content manager, management, e-commerce, portal, search, and insights. And these products are very important for now, because we have more and more transitions from offline to online business, and that's why, and the businesses have to have their unique tools in order to be successful, in order to compete with their rivals inside the web. So, and let's continue with some fundamentals of this company. For now, its total market cap is $57.87 million. It is not so big company for now. And they have a revenue of $11.05 million with a negative net income of $2.35 million. They have a total cash, according to this data, of $3.5 million with a total debt of $2.7 million. And so far, the current ratio is not the best. It is lower than reference level of 1.5, and for now it is 0.8. But we have news that this data is a little bit outdated. And let me show you this. On July the 2nd, we have this article, Bridgeline secures over $2.5 million in warrant exercises. And let me quote you these bullets. US digital engagement company Bridgeline Digital has announced the cash receipt of over $2.5 million in warrant exercises. The additional capital will be used to drive growth and implement the company's e-commerce 360 strategy to increase conversions, traffic, and average order value for its 2,500 customers. So, as you can see, they have a lot of customers, and this is very good that they spread all their revenue among the huge amount of customers. The funds bring the company's cash balance to roughly $6 million. The warrants were issued in 2019 at $4 strike price. Shares up 21.04%. So, for now they have a cash balance around $6 million, and if we add $3.5 million and $2.5 million, we will have roughly $6 million. That's why we have absolutely different current ratio, and that's why I think from the financial standpoint this company is rather stable despite of its negative net income. So let's continue with the next news. On July the 7th we have this article, footwear brand chooses Celebros by Bridgeline to power e-commerce strategy. And let me quote you these bullets. Bridgeline Digital plunges despite announcing its list of footwear brands that trust Celebros search in growing. The brand has online shops all around the world, and the Indonesian subsidiary chose to use Celebros to improve their online experience. They were impressed with Celebros' ability to drive traffic, boost conversions and raise average order value on the other sites in its group, and wanted to see what could be enhanced for this footwear brand. Improving site search is just the first step. There is so much more we can do to maximize their conversions and delight their users, said Ari Khan, president and CEO of Bridgeline Digital. So, as you can see, they have very good testimonials from this customer. But despite of this news, BLIN ticker, BLIN stock plunges for about, let me show it to you, from this top to this level, around 40%. And basically, it is just a retracement, and I will show you in a minute from the technical standpoint why it was rather obvious. Next one we have for this news, meme stock search pushes Xella, B-Square stocks higher. And it was published on July the 6th. And right here you can find this sentence. Digital experience solution provider Bridgeline Digital had 5 mentions. So, I think it is not the huge number of mentions, because the top mentions from Reddit thread community might be hundreds and even thousands of mentions. That's why I don't think that this company is some kind of meme stock. Nevertheless, we have these mentions and they are still there. And that's why you have to be extremely cautious. So, let's continue with the short volume ratio, and according to finviz.com, we have short float of 5.71%. And right here, according to fintel.io, let me show it to you, we have around 28.72% of short volume ratio on July the 6th, 2021. And these discrepancies might be because of different source of information for these numbers. And you have to be cautious with this data. So, and let's continue with the technical analysis. But before we dive deep right here, please subscribe to my channel, hit notification bell and hit the like button. This helps me a lot. So, first of all, let's do an Elliott Wave breakdown for this ticker. And definitely, I think this is the third wave, because we have the highest volume right here inside this wave. And this is the third wave inside the third wave. So, we have this as our first, second, third, fourth and fifth wave. And let me downgrade this degree. And on a slightly bigger picture, we might have something like this. This is the first, second, this entire wave is the third one, fourth and fifth. And we have to slightly upgrade this degree. And here we have absolutely the same 5 waves, first, second, third, fifth, and fourth, sorry, and fifth. And these 2 waves, nothing else but 2 waves on a greater scale. We have, this is our first wave, this is the retracement, third wave right here, fourth retracement. So far we have this information, this data, and fifth to be determined. And this is our highest degree. It might be a minuet degree. And let me clean this chart a little bit. And we have these 2 impulsive waves. But we have a retracement that is on the territory of the wave 1. This means we don't, we cannot have a motive wave inside this movement. That's why we won't have high price targets for the fifth wave. So, let me show you indicators. On 1 hour time frame, as you can see, we are pretty much neutral and we starting to lose negative momentum according to MACD indicator. 2 hours time frame, we have relatively the same picture on MACD. In my opinion, we are at the very bottom and we are exactly at the middle of neutral range according to RSI. And as you can see right here, we had a bearish divergence. Lower high on our side with the higher high on the price action. This means from this point we might have a lower price action, and basically it happened. This retracement happened right after this bearish divergence. And on top of that, this candle, this is the shooting star candle, and this candle usually shows the trend reversal. And as you can see, it has quite good volume compared to other volumes. And that's why from this point we might go to the downside. And it happened. So let's continue with 3 hours time frame. Bearish divergence. Shooting star. 4 hours time frame. Bearish divergence. Shooting star. So we pretty much confirmed the trend, and in my opinion we might have let me measure the retracement so far for the third wave. And as you can see, we've almost hit golden pocket. We exactly hit 0.618 retracement level, and it is also very good point to trend reversal. And in my opinion we might go higher from this point. Let me show you daily and weekly time frame. We have unloaded on daily time frame RSI. This means we have room to grow. And on weekly time frame, yes, so we still in the overbought territory, but in my opinion we might have several days to go to the upside, and then we will have major retracement. So what to expect next? Let me show you. Let me clean again the chart a little bit. In my opinion, we might have one more leg to the upside, but it won't be the biggest. And to project this target, I pulled the Fibonacci extension tool from the bottom of the third wave to the top of the third wave and to the bottom of the retracement. So far, we have this as our lowest point, and as long as this pivot will be our lowest point on the fourth wave, we'll have following target. $16.41 as our primary target and $18.64 for our secondary target. Let me mark it for you. And these targets are legit until this pivot holds. If we will go lower, it will invalidate the entire count, and it might be the false wave and we might hit lower targets. That's why you have to be extremely cautious. So I think from the technical standpoint that's it for now. This trade, when you try to catch the fifth wave, is rather risky, and you have to keep an eye that you might lose the substantial amount of your money. That's why don't invest the amount of money that you're not willing to lose. The most important rule. So with that being said, please subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell and hit the like button. This helps me a lot. See you guys and girls next time. Bye.